I'm Dr. Jesse Hertzberg, and I'm here today to talk to you about what to pack in your bag for delivery. I brought my stuff with me, just as an example. Obviously, whatever is easiest for you is what you should do. Starting off with one thing I think very important is your own toiletries. So different shampoos and soaps that you find comforting, something to have from home. I think this is a must. They have stuff at the hospital, so if you forget, it is not a big deal. But obviously your own toothbrush, your own shampoo and conditioner, much appreciated after a baby. Another thing I like to have at delivery is my own clothes. You won't need these when you deliver. They will put you in a hospital gown. But for afterwards, again, a comfort from home. And remember, you don't go back to normal right away, so make sure your sizes are appropriate. So I like to have different nursing shirts. I like to personally have nursing bras. These are helpful because as your milk is starting to come in, it's more comfortable to have a nursing bra than to not have something on. So these are helpful. And then just different pajamas or loose fitting clothes will feel the most comfortable after baby. I also personally bring blankets for baby. These can be helpful if you need to introduce a baby to a pet at home, or just again, having something that baby can bond with that's just from your house. You may get gifts from people when they come, so some of this stuff might come in too, but I like to have my own. And then I also bring my own clothes. One is for, you know, if you wanna do a little picture for the baby afterwards, if you've had other children and use the same one, this is good for pictures. Otherwise, again, just to have things for baby. In the same lines of breastfeeding, I prefer to have my Boppy or whatever pillow you plan to use for breastfeeding. Reason for this is we can't give you a lot of hands-on before baby, and when you're in the hospital, it's nice to kind of practice what you're going to do at home with the lactation consultants while you're there. So I always bring my Boppy. Camera, always a good reminder. I think we forgot this 2 out of 3 times now. But a camera is good. Also, obviously, if you have your cell phone now, they're much better pictures. Another good thing to remember, chargers. You go through your electronics very quickly. So whether you're bringing an iPad, which I do recommend bringing either an iPad or a laptop, good for communication with outside family, good for just browsing the internet while you're waiting in whatever you're doing in the hospital. But chargers are a good thing to remember. Another thing to remember, if you want, I don't necessarily think this is a necessity, but some people do like having the footprints of baby or their handprints taken, which they can do. They are still sending people home with a little plaque, or I'm sorry, a little poster of it too. So don't worry about it if you forget it. Again, I forgot this with my second completely, so don't worry. But a baby book is helpful. Chapstick is a must. It's very dry in the hospital. And then the last couple things I did bring with me today that I think can be useful. You're going to fill out a lot of paperwork for baby, so make sure you have your social security numbers for both you and your partner. And then you will need, if you want to bring your pump, that's another thing that's kind of person dependent. If you've never used a pump before, bringing yours in, the lactation specialist can help you go through how to use it, so that may be beneficial. If you don't bring your pump, and for whatever reason we need to have you start pumping, there are hospital pumps available and we have the parts. So again, don't worry if you don't, but if you just wanted to figure out how to use it, it would be helpful. And then the last two things I thought of were some of your favorite snacks. So we all get hungry, and especially breastfeeding, having things around that help you drink water, always a good thing. And then sibling gifts. And this again is up to you. We did give our kiddos some sibling gifts when the other ones would arrive. And vice versa, the kids like to give, you know, little brother something. So having these available as well is something that you can bring along. Other than that, I think other things are patient dependent. So if there are things that you have from a comfort from home, some people have fan noise, some people have music, you can bring all of that. Special DVDs, we have all of that that you can use. So just try to bring things from home that you feel will make you comfortable through this experience.